Hey guys, how's it going? So on this video, I kind of want to talk about what I've been up to these past couple of weeks, or maybe just this past week. I'm still in graduate school, and I plan to be a graduate student until, I don't know, it's going to take two more years or something, two more years of this, and then I'll finally graduate with a master's in social work. I made a video before, but what's interesting about the social work major is that field work, field placement is mandatory. So it's required that if I'm to graduate with the master's degree in social work, if I'm to graduate with that, I have to be an intern at a nonprofit agency with some lot of different criteria and requirements. But anyway, requirement is that I have to be an intern 21 hours a week. 21 hours because it's 3 days a week, and it's eight hours a day. But 1 hour is lunch break time, so that's why it's 7 hours actual internship hours per day. 7 times 3, 21. There you go. So 21 hours a week, I have to be an intern at a local nonprofit. The nonprofit I'm working for, and I've mentioned this in another video before, is called Partnership with Children. And they provide social workers to different schools they're partnered with. So I'm currently being an intern at a local high school. And it's a brand new high school, and they really only have a 9th grade class right now. But eventually they'll start including 10th grade class, 11th grade class, you know, as the school actually becomes a full-fledged high school from 9th to 12th grade. But at this point it's just 9th graders, and it's a very small school. And as an intern, I help provide individual counseling therapy sessions, group therapy sessions, case management services, and a whole bunch of other gamut of things that school social workers would do with high school students. And it's really demanding work. I don't know if I've said this before in my YouTube video, but I definitely tweeted this before, that like it's so ironic that the work, the internship, you know, it's unpaid internship. It's so much more demanding and challenging, and in some ways even rewarding too, because it is my passion, than the work that I currently do get paid for. I work my part-time job, I go to a local elementary school, and I'm a classroom tutor, which is interesting. I've never really been a classroom tutor before. For a lot of times in my life, I've been like a private tutor or a tutor at an after-school program. But like an actual classroom tutor, I've never been. And it's very interesting. I pretty much I occupy the same classroom space as one of the teachers. So I'm assigned to one of the teachers, and I'm pretty much assisting the teacher. If students are not in the classroom, I'm assisting the teacher preparing lesson plans, organizing the room, you know, things like that, cleaning up the room, setting up for the next class. And when students are in the classroom, that's when I'm a tutor. You know, I seek out the kids that need help and kind of talk to them. It's an elementary school, and I'm in a science classroom. It's really interesting that I see pretty much all grades except for, I haven't worked with the second graders. That's interesting, actually. But I've worked with pre-kindergartners, kindergartners, first graders, third graders, fourth graders, and fifth graders. Fifth graders being the special education class. So it is interesting that I'm in elementary school and I'm seeing all kinds of grade level students and talking with them. The job to me, being a classroom tutor, for me is kind of like just easy work for me. I don't know why that is for me, but I go in there. There are, you know, certain situations where it's kind of challenging, but for the most part, I have fun there. It's easy for me, and to me, it feels like brainless work or mindless work. You know, what someone might consider as working in McDonald's and just turning over fries, or I don't know. It's I'm not going to compare it to that, but that's the feeling I get. I've done fast food work before. I've done security guard work before. I've done minimum wage jobs before. Except I never really have been paid minimum wage except for as a canvasser. But anyway, beyond that. So yeah, that's ironic to me that the work I do get paid for is so easy, but the internship, it just has taken over my life. Like as the title of this video suggests, I have been, and I'm trying to fix this. But in the recent past, I have been more of an intern than a student, and that's a really weird thing for me because my official title currently in my life, you know, as classroom tutor is a part-time job. I don't really, that's not a label I attach to my identity, you know, but currently, if I get like an application or something, like a government application, like, what is your occupation? Well, currently, my occupation currently is a student. I'm a graduate student. And that's what my overall identity would be and probably should be. But as I say, I feel more like an intern because it really has taken over so much of my life. Now, the internship itself is really demanding work. When I'm there, like, there's so much that I need to do. There's a lot that needs to be done. And it's really demanding work. I actually feel like I'm a social worker in some sense, even though as an intern, there's a lot less responsibilities. I'm only there 3 days a week. I have a lot smaller caseload than a full-fledged, full-time social worker. A lot less responsibilities, such and such. I'm still an intern, you know? So there's that. But fact is, social work intern, the work carries beyond just the internship hours. And that's kind of the challenge. I come home and I still have internship-related things to do. Like, there's paperwork that I didn't get done in my internship. So I end up doing that at home. And that can take a couple of, you know, sometimes it takes as short as 30 minutes. Sometimes it takes as long as an hour or 2 hours. There's that, you know. And I try not to do paperwork at home. I try to make downtime available during my internship to finish that. But sometimes it happens. I come home and I'm doing internship stuff. And then there's the process recordings, which is a requirement. Every week I have to do 2 process recordings. And that's pretty much recording 2 client interactions I had in my internships per week to go over for supervision. That is a time sink. It's very demanding mentally, and it's also very time consuming. And I have to do that every week, twice a week at least, which is actually a lot less than the standard. Standard is 3 process recordings a week, but my supervisor and I agreed 2 is demanding enough. Like, that's pretty much what we can handle, both her and me. So that's that. But, man, this past week, this past Saturday, my midterm paper was due for my diversity class. That's when it, like, really hit me, like, oh my god, I have a midterm due in a couple of days. I have to write this up. The midterm assignment is a 5-page paper, double-spaced, so it's not even that huge of a deal. Actually, that was more challenging to me because I'm a wordy person. I tend to write a lot, and having a maximum 5-page limit, pretty challenging, especially because of considering what the assignment required me to do. I had to interview 2 people at my agency. I had to make 5 citations, and talk about all these different things and answer all these different questions within the 5-page space limit. That was challenging. But like, as I'm preparing for my midterm, I realized, like, I'm just cramming this stuff. I'm just reading this, reading that. And then I also had a classroom presentation for one of my classes. I think it's actually the same class. I don't think I did really that great on that classroom presentation. But it's just like, oh man, I'm cramming schoolwork into my, like, so for example, when I take the bus to my internship, that's a 50-minute bus ride. And I'm just, on my bus ride, I'm just preoccupied with reading the school material and spending as much as I can in that 50-minute time frame to be a student. And then on my way home, I'm doing the same thing on my bus ride. I'm finding little time there to be a student. Granted, when I come home, like, internship has been so demanding that when I come home, I feel so not motivated to do any schoolwork. That's probably the issue with why I had such little time to prepare for my previous midterm. I have 2 midterms due next Saturday. Actually, 1 midterm due next Saturday, and then another midterm due next Tuesday. So, I'm trying to fix this. And what I realized, that fixing this means that I pretty much have no free time. And that's really been the issue the past couple of weeks, because I provided a lot of free time for myself. You know, I've been watching this, I've been watching a lot of Netflix. I've spent some time, like, you know, reading leisurely, playing some video games, hanging out with friends. But being a student and an intern and a part-time classroom tutor kind of means that I really don't have free time to do anything. And it's crunch time, it's midterm time. So that's what I need to do. And it kind of sucks. I know this is kind of very spoiled, you know, spoiled bragging thing, you know, oh, I'm complaining that I have to do work, blah, blah, blah. It's really interesting. What's interesting is a lot of people I know around me, like, oh man, they have no life. They're professionals. Like the social worker that I work with in the high school, she's a social worker, but on Sundays, she's a clinical therapist at a private practice. So she has two jobs. The teacher I assist as a classroom tutor, I know she has two jobs, because at the end of the school day, she's always talking about, like, oh my gosh, I'm going to be late for my second job. And I'm just wondering, like, these, like the need for these people to have two jobs and to really, like, dedicate themselves to two different obligations that like that. It's just crazy to me. Like, I can't, man, that's insane. You know, it's, and on the one hand, it's inspirational. On the other hand, it's kind of intimidating. Like, I can't imagine just living my life, you know, knowing, like, I'm just doing these two jobs at that stage in my life. And I don't know. I just don't want to imagine myself growing older, having that career, and then having two different jobs. You know, people need job and free time and time for themselves and time with friends and family. I think people need that, but I think in a way our society kind of just drives us to keep working and work so hard. It's ridiculous. There was in one of my classes, there was kind of this, like, the professor, I don't know if she was a professor or not, but, like, she made a kind of a quip comment, like, you know, in this profession, we have this competition where who can work the most hours and be the most exhausted and do the most amount of paperwork and casework and all that. There's like this unofficial competition, and it really, really ruins us. And that's what burns us out, I think. Anyway, what I also keep in mind is also that, like, I'm a student now and I'm doing schoolwork and I'm also an intern. And I think, thinking about the future, if my internship in an agency like this, in a nonprofit organization, if that turns into like a full-time job, so instead of being an intern for 3 days a week, I'm a full-time social worker for 5 days a week, I picture that in my mind. If that was all I had, dude, that's totally doable. Like, the challenge right now is being a student, full-time student, and being a part-time classroom tutor, and being a part-time intern. Doing all those three different roles at once, huh, you know, it's doable, but it just means I have no free time, boo-hoo, you know. But if all that I have to do really is just kind of make sure that I take care of myself and make sure that I take care of others in my full-time job, like, that doesn't seem that hard. So in my mind, this feels like the most challenging kind of time of my life, maybe. There have been other more challenging times in the past, of course, when I used to work at a homeless shelter, blah, 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 all that. But I passed through this. I think I'm going to be okay. Anyway, that's just my optimism speaking. Hopefully I'm right.